Alright guys, hi. It is crap. What is it? Anyway, today's. It is Tuesday. Tuesday the 22nd? Yeah. So it is July 22nd. It is a few days after my show this past Saturday. I have been totally MIA and I barely have any footage of the show because I was so stressed out, just like, and busy. Stressed out, busy, running around, getting, you know, all dolled up and stuff. So I really didn't get to take a lot of footage of it. I will upload some pictures and some videos that I did take. And it'll just be, like, random stuff, not really in any order, just to kind of give you an idea of what the day was like. But it's hectic, and the girls out there that do video blogs, my leg is still really, really tan. Or, I guess, orange. Whee! Compared to my face that I scrubbed off. It's hard. It's hard, especially when you're, like, when you're backstage by yourself, and you're trying to do a million things, like your hair, makeup, and you don't even think of your cell phone. Like, I had people calling me and texting me, and I was just, like, in my own zone, getting ready. And I was the first division out. Bikini goes first, so it was, like, rush on stage, do everything, blah, 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 prejudging. It was just, it was insane. Needless to say, I placed second in novice, and I placed third in open. So, I'm very happy with that. I did a lot of hard work. I've been dieting for 6 months now. So this is my third show this year. And this is the first year I've done any shows. So, my body's really hurting right now. Honestly, I had a little bit of time where I was bulking. And I stopped bulking in May. And by bulking, I mean I was having, like, 1,600 calories. Woo! And then I got down to 1,000, like, the week of the show, which is so unhealthy, and no one should ever do that. I did it because I was stubborn, and I wasn't losing fat fast enough because my metabolism shut down. My fault, no one else's fault, I don't have a coach. I did it all myself. It also comes into the fact that I do come from a background that has an eating disorder, so in a way it was kind of like, I don't even know how it's a masochistic type of thing going on, which is unhealthy. So it's hot. I'm waving my feet around. Okay. So that's never good. So now that it is post show, my plan is, I'm reverse dieting currently. I had 2 days. I had Saturday and Sunday where I kind of did whatever I wanted. Excuse me. Sleep. I don't know what time it was. 9 o'clock at night, I think. But Saturday, I made a ton of cupcakes and brownies and Rice Krispie treats for all the competitors. So the show ran late. Awards went forever. And I also helped clean up post-show. So I was starving. I didn't leave the venue until like 10:30. So I ended up having 2 cupcakes and 2 brownies after awards while I was cleaning up because I was starving. So by the time we got to a restaurant, I wasn't really even hungry. So I got a salad. I got a salad and fried calamari. That was my post-show meal. And then the next day, Sunday, was National Ice Cream Day apparently. And there's a new restaurant that opened up on the beach called The Goat. My friend, two of my friends opened it. And I've been dying to go there. It's a country bar with burgers and whiskey. I hate whiskey, but I love burgers. And so I got what was called the Walk of Shame. This was Sunday, mind you. So I actually had to work Sunday morning. So I worked until noon. Then I came home and took a nap. And had an omelet. And then I waited for Tom to come home. And then we went out to eat super late at night. It was 9 o'clock on Sunday when we went out, so I could have, like, a real cheat meal. And so I got the Walk of Shame burger. At first, for appetizers, we got a bucket of bacon. like the most perfectly cut and like cooked seasoned whatever bacon in the world, and they have this maple dipping sauce. It tastes like sriracha and maple syrup mixed together, and you just dip pieces like bacon slices. And that was our appetizer. Yep. Awesome. Then I got what was called the Walk of Shame burger. Beef burger. And it had a fried egg on top that I don't like over easy eggs. It's supposed to be over easy, but that's gross to me. So I asked for over hard. With sweet potato fries. What else came with it? Sweet potato fries. And what they have is goat sauce, which is like a cilantro, lime, mayonnaise type thing. I hate mayonnaise, but I just went with it because whatever. And there was something else that went on that was awesome that I don't remember. Oh, and then I asked for ghost pepper chili cheese. So, it was amazing. I don't think I could ask for a better burger. Oh, there's also bacon on that burger too. Bacon. So, that's what I had. I had a vodka Diet Coke. Fancy. Or cherry vodka Diet Coke. And I also had some fries. And yeah, that was my real cheat meal. And then after that, since it was National Ice Cream Day, I had to get some ice cream. So I got some Almond Joy ice cream, which is awesome. I haven't had real ice cream since last summer. And then what else did I have with it? I had two scoops. I don't even remember what the other one was. Make something up. That's what, mint Oreo cookie. There we go. And tons of sprinkles and a cone, because that's the only way to have ice cream, with sprinkles. So that was yesterday, and then, or that was Sunday. And so Monday I started reverse dieting. So what I'm doing right now is, I've looked into it a lot, and I just decided to start at 1400 calories, or I think it's like 1410, I don't know. I went on to, if it fits your macros, researched a little bit and decided that was the best one to start with because it was not too low, and I just wanted to have a good base amount because I'm actually going to be training for 5K for next week, so I do need the fuel, even though I should probably start lower, closer to where I ended, but I don't care. Starting at around 1400, my fat is at 25%, which comes to 30 grams, I think. And my carbs are at 120. So that's actually kind of a lot. That's the most carbs I've had in a couple months. It's crazy. That's not even that much. So that's where I'm starting. And then protein, I think, is at like 150. So I'm slowly going to be adding carbs and then changing the protein to carbs and then adding more. Since I started at such a low carb ratio, I'm slowly changing that. I don't want to mess with my body too much. I'm probably going to be adding like 50 calories a week, maybe more. I'm going to measure my weight and everything else, try and do bi-weekly fat analysis just to see, just because I'm curious how fast my body's going to respond. It's probably going to lose weight. Right now I'm kind of bloated because I've had a lot of salt and crap and stuff, and today was the first day I actually went back to the gym, and I actually stayed for like 2 hours because I like working out. I did shoulders, chest, and tries, and then I burned 150 calories on the treadmill because I wanted to run a mile, which came to 150 calories. Tomorrow I'm probably going to run another mile, and then tomorrow's glute day because it's hump day. So, yeah. So that's that. My goals right now, building my metabolism, and that's the biggest one because it's totally shot. That, and I want to build a healthier relationship with food because even having the cheat meals made me freak out, like mentally it made me freak out because I just was like, I don't want to get fat. And right now I don't really have like super defined abs, but when I wake up in the morning, they're there, and then as soon as I eat and stuff, they're gone. But that's because I also added dairy and everything else back to my diet, and salt and sugar and whatever. So, That's the goal. Reverse dieting. I have a 5K next Tuesday. And I have at some point this summer, I don't know when, there's one race I'm looking at right now. It's the ROC race. It's Ridiculous Obstacle Course Race, which is awesome to me. That, I think it's the first week in August, so kind of boom, boom, boom with all these different things. But I also really want to get back into fighting. Fighting is obviously, like, that's my passion. I miss it so much. I couldn't do it the past 6 months because I've been just, like, depleted as all hell. And now that I'm going to be reverse dieting, getting my body back to normal, I'll be able to heal. I'll be able to have energy to do these grueling, like, getting punched in the face for hour workouts. So, you can see the difference in my leg versus my face. That's hilarious. So, that's kind of the goal. And eventually, I do want to get a fight. I know that there's a hybrid fight, kind of like mixed martial art, like MMA, but you wear face mask and like, what else do you wear? I don't know. There's like a lot of weird protection, safety precautions that you have to wear because it's a karate organization that does it, so it's a little different. But the last two fights I've done that were hybrid, I've won, so I figured it'd be fun, maybe, or I'll just do a grappling tournament. I don't know, but I'm just relaxing right now. It's hard to not have a goal, so that's why I have the races. So, just gonna keep building muscle, gonna keep working on being fighting fit, because that's what I miss. So, a lot of shoulders, try and work up my endurance a little bit more, try and get faster. And that's the plan right now. So it is hot as balls in my room. I'm gonna go downstairs, and I just had some Arctic Zero, which is awesome, but I'm gonna go downstairs and get a amino acid popsicle, because there's nothing in it, and I have no more macros. So, that's that for Tuesday. That's the recap. The show was amazing. It really was. I met some amazing people. I really did. Met a lot of people that, girls did diet, didn't diet, counted macros, just bro dieted. Everyone came out completely different. It was really cool. I know next time I need a different suit, more glutes, a little bit leaner. I was very lean, but, just for myself, I want to be leaner. I want to feel ready 2 weeks beforehand instead of, like, the week of. Also, change my hair and makeup. Other than that, and then work on posing. Because I practice a lot, but I get nervous, so I kind of just, like, forgot everything. Those are the things I really want to work on. No clue when I'm going to do another show. I kind of want to do one in November. Just because a friend's doing it, and I kind of want to, it'd be a fun road trip. Who knows? I don't want to diet down again. If I stay the leanness where I'm at, which is the goal, which is what I want to do, I don't want to gain maybe like 1 or 2% fat back, but that's it. If anything, I'd rather be leaner, because I don't think I'm really that lean. So as long as, if I can not diet down, that'd be awesome. And if I just look amazing and then just maintain, build more muscle, then I'll decide to do the show. Otherwise, I'm not gonna do any crazy dieting. I need to really build. So that's pretty much that. So until next time, I'll upload a bunch of random stuff soon. So yay.